Hello everyone, and welcome back to another video of Storlytics Energy Storage Made Simple. Today we will discuss augmentation and how you can leverage Storlytics software to optimize your augmentation schedule to maximize the profit of your project. The most conventional method of accounting for degradation is simply oversizing the battery to deliver the intended amount of energy till the end of life. While this is a good and straightforward solution, it fails to consider potential cost reduction of battery energy storage, improving technology, and its impact on degradation and energy density. Augmentation, on the other hand, can be used to maintain capacity or performance at a specific level by the end of the project. While having a lower initial installed capacity than the overbuild strategy, it can also potentially be utilized to increase the plant capacity beyond its original capacity. There are different flavors of augmentation to select from. On a high level, they can be put into two distinct categories, DC and AC-based augmentation. In DC augmentation, a new battery rack is installed behind an existing inverter, parallel to the older battery rack. In another format, the older battery racks can be redistributed and all the new racks can be installed behind one inverter. Whereas AC augmentation, a new inverter battery system is added to the existing fleet of inverter battery skids. AC and DC augmentation in battery energy storage systems have different design approaches and applications. AC augmentation is generally more flexible and easier to integrate with existing grids and loads. In contrast, DC augmentation offers higher efficiency and faster response time, especially when coupled with other DC sources or loads. The choice between AC and DC augmentation depends on the specific requirements of the energy storage system and its intended application. AC augmentation is the focus of this video, and it's the easier and more reliable way to increase project capacity steadily over time. This is based on several factors. Point number one, no additional devices required like DC to DC converters to manage voltage levels between newer and older battery racks. Point number two, BMS control strategy disparity. And point number three, the different internal resistance causes the newer racks to have different charge-discharge behavior. For this video, which is focused on AC augmentation, we will focus on developing an augmentation schedule and optimizing operational value over creating the POI profile itself. Let's assume the battery we are modeling today is a grid-scale market-facing battery that helps into services like energy arbitrage, regulation services, spinning reserves, etc. We have an example profile here that includes all the services that we will be using to determine the battery energy storage system degradation and flyback. The profile generation assumed a battery of 50 megawatt and usable energy of 100 megawatt hour. This is to be considered as end-of-life capacity. The idea of augmentation is to build up the needed end-of-life capacity with AC augmentation. The first augmentation phase can be a higher installed capacity to maximize the benefits assigned to the ancillary service. In this example, the initial installed capacity is 20 megawatt, and the objective is to have a 4-hour operation throughout the life of phase 1 battery. Once we deduce degradation and the life cycle of phase 1, installation dates for other steps or phases can be decided. Storlytics report generated shows us the state of health curve throughout project life. This can also be found in the output CSVs of your Storlytics folder. Here, the end of life for the first phase is 20 years. End of life is widely considered to be when the battery energy storage reaches 70% of its state of health. Based on the degradation, the beginning of life capacity can be determined such that at 20 years or the end of life, the project can sustain a 4-hour operation. Once phase 1 is modeled, phase 2 initial build year can be assumed. The subsequent phases can be assumed to have an earlier start so as to be participate in the Energy Storage Tax Incentive and Deployment Act. Here we have assumed that phase 2 starts at year 9. Inverter replacement is scheduled after 15 years of operation based on equipment life, warranties and maintenance plan provided by several inverter manufacturers. If we look at the degradation, we can align phase 1 battery energy storage system cell replacement with inverter replacement. This can potentially save owners on plan downtimes and having to allow for personnel to work on the plan for equipment replacement. In the final augmentation sheet, we can see that each augmentation cycle can be aligned with the scheduled replacement or installed to reduce downtime of the plant. The POI energy and power graphs showcase how the plant is built up to the final end-of-life capacity of 50 megawatt and 200 megawatt hours in duration. In the next series of videos, we will explore other kinds of augmentation and how users can leverage Storlytics software to design their battery energy storage system more efficient. Thank you and see you in the next video.